Oh, howdy everybody! Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be doing a makeup look inspired by the Hailey Bieber little peaches makeup challenge, which is really cute. Their little like wifey hubby, her and Justin thing. He comes out with a song named Peaches. She does the peaches viral little makeup challenge. Adorable. Love it. And I love Hailey Bieber and follow her on Instagram, and she's been posting all of the people's like challenge looks on her stories. And I thought that was really great, but she posted this one chicky poo, okay? Makeup by Jess Evans. And I squealed. I actually audibly squealed out loud. I saw this look and I was like, oh my God, I've proceeded to creep absolutely everything this woman has done. Her makeup looks incredible and I have saved so many looks. Shout out to her for being fabulous. And hey, Hailey Bieber, thanks for sharing the people with us in the world. And I wanted to do a look inspired by this, inspired by the little peachy vibe. Love that color, love the idea for spring. And so to you, Makeup by Jess Evans, thank you for inspiring this day. Let's try to create a fabulous peachy look. Let's zoom you in and create a peachy makeup look. Okay, we're gonna start with the eyes. I've already done my brows. I saved us all from that pain. It's just been taking me a really long time to do my eyebrows these days, so just did that ahead of time. I'm gonna take my concealer. This is my Makeup Forever self-setting concealer. I'm gonna use this first, blend it out with a beauty blender, and just put this all around the eye to get a lovely little base going. Do-do-do-do-do. So the first thing I'm going to do is put some bronzer into the sockets, the creases. This is the L'Oreal bronzer in the shade Sunkissed. I'm just gonna take this on a big fluffy brush, and I'm just going to be placing that all in the crease, getting a nice good little blend out. This is a Smith Cosmetics 232 brush, and she actually has this look quite far out. Well, actually, she's just got really fabulous brow bone situation going on. She's just got a lot of lid space to play with, but I'm basically just continuing the bronzer out past my brow. Can you kind of see that? It's just going like creating that little cat eye bronze to chisel out there. And then in the crease, she's got like a really bright peachy orangey, but like soft shade kind of following from that. And I didn't have one really in my collection. I actually have a few of these MAC shades, but they're just a little bit more brown and then they just go like quite orange. So I actually thought I would try using my Wet n Wild blush. This one's in the shade Keep It Peachy. I thought that was kind of a great looking match. We'll have to see once it's actually on. It might not be as vibrant as we wish, but I wanted to try it anyway before we come to such hasty conclusions. So let's try this and just pack it in there and get a really peachy feel going on. You know what? I think that's peachy. And it's perfect because then we can multitask later and use this blush as our blush and it'll be matching, right? Okay, so I'm basically just following the same shape and kind of just dragging that in the whole outer corner of the eyelid as well. Just really softly. This is a Smith 230 brush. Yeah, that's really peachy. Love that. Oh, what a pretty eyeshadow color this blush is. Go Wet n Wild. Okay, love that. So peachy. So next up, she takes an eyeshadow base and puts that all over the lid and layers a pink eyeshadow on top. I'm gonna take my NARS Tinted Smudge Proof eyeshadow base. This one's in the shade Light. I've had this one for a really long time. I wonder if it's gonna be expired at some point. I'm gonna work that onto the lid, and this is going to help brighten up the space where we are putting the pink and hopefully make it pop a bit more. Like that. Like that. I am holding my breath so hard while I do this, trying not to make any sudden movements and smudge this around. This is one step in my eyeshadow that I don't do often. I recall, like, the one time I did this was when I was trying to do a cut crease. I think we did a pretty good job. It was a fun video to film, if anyone remembers that. But this is definitely something I should do with eyeshadow more often, putting a little base to just make the color pop a little bit more and give that lid a bit of a chiseled effect. I quite like it. Like, even if you did this, blended it out a bit, eyeliner, like, it's cool, you know? It does some cool things for the eyes. I don't mind it. And these tinted NARS bases are phenomenal. So for the pink, I'm a little bit undecided where to go for this. I was trying to find a pink that looked similar to hers. I didn't have the exact eyeshadow palette she was using, so I tried to pull some. I have this MAC individual shadow in the shade Coral, which would give more of a coral vibe, but hers is like quite pink, and I kind of like the contrast between the peach in the crease and then the bright pink on the lid. I also have my Jackie Ina Anastasia Beverly Hills palette that has this shade Supreme. So I was thinking of trying this. That was like the closest pink I could find to what she used. So let us perhaps just go with that. Shout out to Jackie Ina for this fabulous palette. It's been a long time since I've played in this one. Hot dog. Okay, so I'm gonna take a Smith 256 brush. I'm gonna load up the shade Supreme from that palette. And we're gonna press this on to the base. Oh yeah, you know, that looks really similar. Yay, I'm happy. I'm happy that worked out. Okay, great. So I'm just gonna pack that all over. Oh, I'm so sorry, pardon me. I'm gonna pack that all over the lid. Then we're just gonna dip a little bit more into the blush shade and just make sure that this is all softly chiseled out. Just diffused. We are diffusing this little moment here. I think we need more pink. I think actually the pink needs to come a little bit higher. It feels a little separated. Okay, this little brush I'm using right now, this is the Katie Jane Hughes Spectrum brush, number 19. It's so soft and so fluttery as I'm putting this onto the eyes. It just feels magical. I thought I should let you know. I was gonna go back in again with the peach over top. Woo. I think I'm happy with that. I'm just gonna take a little wipe and attempt to draw a line for our liner to follow. And I love that in this look she used a brown eyeliner. Does that look even? I can never tell. Looks okay to me. I'm gonna take this brown eyeliner from MAC, and it looks like she's just got a half liner, then she does a half lash with some mascara. So I'm going to attempt to do the same here. So I'm gonna start it at the center of my eye, drag it out and try and follow the line. This is the best eyeliner I've ever used. The easiest to get a perfect wing. It is almost completely foolproof. I love this one so much. Okay, then I'm going to apply mascara. I'm gonna use my Lancôme Lashy Doll and put a good healthy coating of this on the upper lashes. Time for lashes, my biggest struggle. I pulled out the classic Ardell Demi Wispies. I'm gonna try to do a half lash using these. Do a little snipperoo here. Hold on, let me get my tweezers here so I don't rip the lashes off. That always happens. I always end up like ripping the lashes when I'm just trying to take them out of the packaging. But I think I'm gonna try like actually sizing these. Just a little half snip there, and I'm just gonna cut the other one to make sure it's even. Then I have my duo lash glue on lock, and I just take a little Q-tip and apply it onto the lashes. You know what? I just need to go back to my individual lash life because I just can't get strip lashes to work for me. I really can't. Nope, I can't. We are diving back into the individual land, my friends. See you in 30 years when I'm done applying these. Done. We've applied some individual lashes. We've got a little nice wispy looking half lash going on. Let us move on to the face. Strobe cream. I'm going to take my MAC Gold Light strobe cream. I'm going to apply this all over the face. I'm going to take my Maybelline Blur Stick and just put that onto these inner parts of my face where I'm extra porous. For foundation, I'm going to use my Makeup Forever Reboot Foundation. I have this one in the shade Y244. I'm just putting that into the palm of my hand. I'm going to spread it out on my face with my finger. Just dot it around. And then I take my beauty sponge and just blend that around, making sure to not rub away any of the eyeliner that we've put down. I'm going to take the Katie Jane Hughes number 10 brush, and just with a little excess of that foundation, I'm going to do it very Patrick Ta style, where I'm just going to get right in there around the eye. Just before we go in and place any more concealer around. Then I'm going to take my Makeup Forever self-setting concealers. I have these in 30 and 31.5. I'm going to take 30 and use that to brighten up the under eye area and just down the center of the face. And then I'm going to use 31.5 just to go in where I need a little bit of extra concealing. I've got a few spots up here on my forehead. I'm going to go around it basically right here on my mouth. And maybe for good measure, we'll just do a little whoop swipe there. And then you blend it all out with the beauty sponge. Next, I'm going to chisel the face. She used Nude Sticks Bondi Bay in her little video tutorial on Instagram. So I too am going to pull this out and contour my face using this. Time for powder, Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder. I'm going to take that down the center of my face. This is the Katie Jane Hughes 08 brush. Definitely putting that here under the eyes where I don't want any movement. We want to have an extra smoothing, blurring effect there. And because my pores are just like really bad right here on my cheeks, I always press the powder right there too and just kind of carry it down around the mouth. I don't want like this area looking shiny, right? I could probably put a little here on the cheeks too, just a little dusting. I'm gonna do one layer of the bronzer, just a little layer of powder bronzer. We're pretty bronzed, we're good. I just like to layer it. I find it always makes it look a little bit more softer and diffused when you're layering up your products. So I'm just doing a nice dusting of that around. Woo, 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 woo. And actually, while we have this bronzer in hand, let's take a lovely... Oh, you know what? That brush is too thick. Hold on. Losing track of my brushes here. Let's take a little layer of that bronzer and just put it on the lower lash line. I'm doing this to kind of set the tone. But what I actually want to do is go in with the peach, the blush. We're going to do a little wash of this too on the lower lash line and just bring it all together. Yeah, love that. It's so nice and soft under there. I think she actually has a little bit of light liner on the waterline. I'm going to take my NARS, I believe this is, Rue Bonaparte. Just put the lightest little layer of that in the waterline. Sorry, I'm kind of jumping around here, but yeah. I think that just brightens it up a little bit. Let's put some mascara on the lower lashes as well. And I'm just taking my finger and running along the bottom of that to try and take off some of the excess product so we don't raccoon as easily. And let's take that blush and apply it onto the apples of our cheeks. She's got a little bit more pink in the cheeks. So I'm going to start with this, and maybe we'll just put the tiniest bit of the shadow onto the cheeks. Would that be too crazy? too risky. Yeah, I feel like the cheeks aren't popping like hers are. She's got quite a pink hue in there. Maybe I'll take this brush. This is really nice and light and fluffy. This is the Katie Jane Hughes 04 brush. Really lightly dip it into that pink shadow. I'm gonna just rub it into the palm of my hand. It feels so weird. It's literally powder. Like, it's no different, truly, right? To just put it there. Okay, well, at least we know what matches the eye. All right, guys, that's the eyeshadow on the cheeks. Let's move on to lips. I'm gonna take my Charlotte Tilbury Iconic Nude lip liner. And I didn't have any of the products she used on her lip, but it did just look like a glorious nude lip with a slightly like peachy pinky gloss on top. So let's see what we come up with here. We might try a couple of different options, but I'm gonna line the lips regardless. Oh my God, it happened again. You guys, I didn't rub out. Oh, wow, it's been so long since I've done that. I totally forgot to blend out the contour on my lip. Oh, if that was driving you crazy over the last however many minutes, I am so sorry. It is not the first time. I'm glad we saw it though. Oh my goodness. I'm gonna take a little bit of the Vive Muse 90s lipstick. No, I need something more pink. Let's try this combo. I'm gonna use Kyra Weiss Calm, this little peachy nude lipstick. A little less gray here. Okay, and then this Charlotte Tilbury Refresh Rose. Refresh Rose, this lovely little lip gloss. Kinda. And then let's spritz with the Benefit Porefessional. All right, friends, this is it. This is she. This is everything for this makeup look. Let me know in the comments down below how you guys think I did. Thank you so much to Makeup by Jess Evans for this stunning inspo. I'm actually quite obsessed with this eyeshadow look, and I feel like I just need to sit like this so that you can see the full effects of the peachy sunset that is happening on my eyelids right now. Super cool to see the little peachy makeup challenge. And if you guys do a similar look, I would love to see what you create. Please send me your pics, tag me in your pics. I'm at Alanorama everywhere. And let me know what you think of this look for spring, these peachy spring feelings. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. And I'll see you all very soon for a new video. Bye!